Hey everyone, I'm Brian CrowMn and welcome to A CrowMn Review, still celebrating the 25th anniversary of Street Fighter. Now, last time I showed you guys how to celebrate 15 years a little late, but thankfully Capcom had their shit together in 2008. 20th anniversary mode, activate! So let's get things straight right off the bat. 2008, the 20th anniversary of Street Fighter. Kind of a big deal, but the series hadn't seen a title in well over a decade. And all these little updates and compilations released over the years could really only satisfy a fighting game fan for so long. Capcom answered with Street Fighter 4 a year later, but if you pre-ordered from GameStop, you got one hell of a unique prize. This headband! Now you too can nerdgasm over the prospect of emulating Street Fighter's icon Ryu by donning his signature headband. 100% cotton. None of that synthetic polyester, bull. Sporting both the Street Fighter 4 and 20th anniversary logo, just wearing it makes me want to shoryuken my enemies into dust! That means you, David Arquette. Motherfucker. Anyways, I suppose it's on to our next feature item. A 20th anniversary commemorative coin. You'll have to excuse the rough appearance though, I actually carry that coin with me just about everywhere I go because—
It's about what's fair!
No, I carry the coin
because— I got here the same way the coin did.
Sure, yeah, I guess, but you know, the interesting thing about the coin is actually the packaging that it comes in. I actually meant the back. There we go. Which actually gives a little timeline spark notes, if you will, of Street Fighter history. So let's dive right in and take a closer look. Alrighty, 1988. The series has humble beginnings as an arcade game released in 1987, and released on the TurboGrafx a year later. So that was probably the most poorly written start to a timeline that I've ever seen in my entire life. Seriously, what the hell happened there? They should have just started with 1987, since that's when Street Fighter was actually released, and then used 1988 to boast about its release on the TurboGrafx instead of that awkwardly worded jumble. Further down, we see that Capcom doesn't afraid to admit their equally terrible and hilarious days, as 1994 mentions the Street Fighter movie, and 1995, Street Fighter, the movie, the game. Conspicuous by its absence, though, where the hell is Street Fighter 3 on that timeline? 1997, you put Super Puzzle Fighter. And not Street Fighter 3? And what's this? Wyclef Jean croons about Chun-Li and his rendition of Guantanamera? You know, I've actually never heard that song before, but Wyclef Jean doing a song about Chun-Li, that actually sounds pretty awesome. So let's give that a listen. Hit it.
Welcome to the carnival.
Cool and everything, but I thought this was supposed to be a song about Chun-Li. Where's the Chun-Li part? Where's the Chun-Li part?
Better yet, Space Invader, if your name was Charlie, we'd be playing Street Fighter.
Really? That's it? A vague Chun-Li reference in a song that wasn't even really a big hit back then? That makes the timeline? Fucking Street Fighter 3 doesn't make the timeline, but Wyclef Jean gets highlighted on this thing? Fuck it, moving on. Street Fighter evolves with Fighting Evolution. Capcom Fighting Evolution. Capcom Fighting Jam. Capcom Fighting Jam. I'm Brian CrowMn for A CrowMn Review, still celebrating the 25th anniversary of... Why the hell wasn't Street Fighter 3 on that fucking timeline? Fuck!
Do you speak English? Can I buy you a drink?
Soy una mujer sincera. De donde eres, en la palma.
You kill it.
Y antes que morir, yo quiero cantar mis versos del alma.
Te quiero, mamá. Te quiero. Te quiero.
Guantanamera.
Hey, yo, I'm standing at the bar with a Cuba cigar. She's eyeing me from far.
Guantanamera, Guajira, Guantanamera.
Yeah, she was the rose of Spanish Harlem. Mama Cita, beg your pardon. Made stakes at a faster rate than she fornicates. Good traits of genius. Got us a black Venus. Crab niggas angry cause they can't get between us.
Hey, hey everyone, it's me again. Just want to let you guys know you could subscribe to A CrowMn Review's YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button located that way, or you could follow me on Twitter by clicking the link down in the description below. That's it. We'll see you next time.